Hi guys, this is Roy and welcome to another brand new video on this channel. So do you own multiple wireless devices like tablet, PC, mobile phone, smart TV and you also connect them using some kind of Wi-Fi network, right? I also used to have this kind of network in my home, but the main problem I faced is transferring or sharing file between my devices. Like when I transfer file between my computer to my mobile phone, I generally connect with the data cable and transfer whatever I need. And when I download some movie on my computer, then I want to watch this movie on my big screen TV, I generally copy the movie on pen drive and attach it to my TV and watch it. So last week I set up a wireless cloud in my home and it's really cheap. It costs you less than $100 and I am getting near about 40 to 50 Mbps speed over Wi-Fi. It's insanely fast and now I can share my file, I can watch 4K videos over Wi-Fi. It's awesome. So in this video I'm going to share with you guys how you can do that too. So let's get started. So this is the router I use on my network. The model number is RTN10U. It cost me around $30. There is a USB port on the back and you can connect a hard drive or pen drive with it. I thought like I can access it from anywhere and that's really cool, but the speed is so slow. I get only 3 to 4 Mbps maximum with this router. I did some research and tried to find out what is the best and cheapest way to set up a NAS or network attached storage at home. In total, using a 1TB hard drive, it costs you around $130 to $150. In case if you don't have a portable hard drive and you are thinking about buying one, I suggest you check the Xiaomi Mi R1D AC Wi-Fi router, which has a built-in 1TB hard drive and price is little less than $100. And couple of days ago, Gigabite sent me this router. Let's open this box. Wow, this is the router itself. The router has a nice piano finished looks like a WD MyBook external hard drive. It's lightweight and build quality is average. On the back of the router, we have 12 volt power input, then a reset button, then one port followed by 2GB LAN port and a USB port. The router is super powerful and it powered by 1GHz dual core processor and 256MB RAM, which is more than enough for any home user. Let's see what we have. I think this is a manual. This is another manual. Let's look at it later. And in this box we have a power brick. Let me zoom. It's a 12 volt 2.5 amp power brick. Let's see what else we have, and we have a converter for Indian power supply. Now let's power it on. Now let's set up the router. It's super easy and you can do it even using your phone. Just connect with the router Wi-Fi and it automatically open a browser and setup wizard will appear. Then follow the instructions. If the setup wizard not appear automatically, find the default gateway. It is the IP of the router and then type it on the address bar. For this router it is 192.168.31.1. Then hit enter. Accept the term and condition and click OK. Then put the password, OK, instead. It just takes only 2 clicks to set up your own home multi-gigabyte cloud storage. Isn't cool? This is the GUI, web-based GUI of the router. I think it's super simple, but it's not for advanced user. If you are really advanced user, this router is not for you. If you attach a big USB hard drive, it takes time to scan and indexing those files in it by the router. If you are not able to access USB drive, please go to download apps, then download the apps according your OS, Windows, Mac, Android, whatever you are using. And you also need a AMI user ID password to use the app. Talking about Wi-Fi range and performance, it supports dual band 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi range is much better than 5 GHz, but file transfer speed is slow compared to 5 GHz. It able to cover my 1200 square feet house without any problem.
while all penetration mode is turned on. I tested file transfer speed with my laptop within 10 feet range. The 5 GHz Wi-Fi file transfer is 40 to 60 Mbps. After a single wall, signal strength dropped to minus 55 dBm and I get up to 30 Mbps. After two walls, it's 70 dBm and max speed is up to 50 Mbps. Then three walls, near about 2 to 7 Mbps. After fourth wall, there is no signal at all. At this price point, the performance is pretty good. I transferred more than 100 GB file over Wi-Fi without any interruption. And I was able to stream 4K video on my Xiaomi Mi 5 like buttery smooth without any buffer at all. Even I able to stream 4K video simultaneously on 3 devices over Wi-Fi without any lag. All of the devices shown, the link is in the description below so you can check them. And thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end. Hope you like this video. If you like it, make sure you smack the like button. And don't forget to hit the red subscribe button. It helped me a lot. And if you have any question, any suggestion, make sure you comment in the comment section below. That's being said, my name is Roy. I'm signing out. Meet with you on my next video. Till then, tata, bye bye, and peace out.